Okay. We are looking at recapping at Portalices, which is just basic ports out of here. We're looking at one port here out of three. Two are there on the side. This one's Pulvis Arctis, which is actually just a giant tree stump that was going all the way up through the porch. And this port being ripped open like this basically sends all of the mist of the black hole out. So everything that's within this pie here is actually very potentially strange and unusual, like what's inside the hole. I can get into that in a second, but we've already kind of went over it numerous times. But this is just for the new people. So this port of Pulvis Arctis of the ground, which is the bottom, this is the foundation, has a port that goes into a giant hole, which they will call the horizon, for eye zone. So this whole earth and everything is all female, and they have these degrading names for like horizon, you know, countries, and there's no countries and there's no continents. Interesting con. So yeah, as you can see here, it divides itself up into fours, and there's precious resources, amazing resources here, very plentiful, which I imagine this aurora borealis must blow mostly this direction. And when it, the black hole sun has the ability to take power over anything, it will create things that are like it around it. So you'll probably see shellac welt coming out here, or Shraffalan, or the land of plenty, like spilling out. Now, what is the land of plenty? Notice that there's mountains obstructing it all around, so you can't see in here. These are all quarry waste mounds, all created into mountains or molehills, things that are treacherous and are hard to get over. Alright. Sounds like a bunch of craziness, which I would assume that everyone should say, because I would think that if I didn't know. But here, there's the map right there of it, Shraffalan. That's what happens when you go in that port. If you go down Portalices, down to the bottom, you're in the Black Hole Sun Kingdom, which is also known as Shraffalan, where all of these things are very plentiful and full of resources, and they never end and it never will end. And you can live there forever, and you stay frozen in perpetual twilight, in which you don't die. And then it spirals off like that. If you look at my video, or the Black Sun, composite on a fake ball Earth, that's pretty much what it looks like. And it sits up in the sky, like really high up, and people speak into it, and things fall out of the void hole, which create all of these landscapes that are just pretty much unbelievable. There's just more information about it. This basically just tells you what to expect on those. So I've been keeping track of a lot of these maps. They just tell you what to expect on the surrounding islands, because you kind of need to know, you know, what to expect. That's what fell. It was a dirt devil. Imagine that. Alright, so, yeah. As you can see, it's been done over and over again. There's no reason to assume that this place does not exist. And once you go inside of the hole, I'm assuming this is what's spilling out on the outside, on the top. But, once you get into it, it's pretty much just this. And this is what that song is about. You're gonna go to the land down under. And you better run, you better take cover. They're saying go underground. That's basically what they're saying. You hear that thunder? All right, so yeah. Once again, excessive eating and luxuries, but it's not really about that. It's about, you know, people on Earth know what it's really about. They call it the Ship of Fools because, as you know, people have been dumbed down here too. And if they weren't dumbed down, they can't be harmed. You know, can't be harmed here. But if you weren't dumbed down, or the masses wasn't dumbed down, then they would be coming out telling you to come down here. They'd be like, yo, man, come down here and fucking just chill. Ain't nobody getting hurt. Nowhere, man. So as you can see, it's obviously it exists. Well, the graduate, the university graduate wears the black robe of the god Saturn and the motherboard of Freemasonry. Both are very ancient symbols. In which the Chattel class graduates with the mortarboard slave hat on their head, completely unaware that they are pushing their own demise, in which they are, as I should say, what should I say, captive of the Great Seal of the United States. Look on the back of your dollar. The back of your dollar has the eye, all-seeing eye, right? Underneath it, it says the Great Seal, right? On the other side, it says of the United States. So, that is the Great Seal of the United States, in which the motorboard-wearing, civilly dead citizens are to be devoured because they follow the beast, and they would be being devoured willingly. So that's what all this is. Or, you can get away. That's what this is all about. This is all about the promised land, the land of milk and honey. As it says on the Bible, this is the tree of Eden, the stump that was cut down. And you pretty much know what to do. There's Canada over here. You go north from Canada. You can go from the Orient or Greenland, which I think is right there. It leads right to it. So yeah, you can get to it fairly easily. And it's only 60 miles off of here, like maybe 30 miles, because that's 30 miles wide, so that's like 30 miles. And that's about 60 miles, so it's nothing. It's really easy to get to. And it doesn't take much effort, you just need to dress warm. At least until you cross about the 70th or 80th parallel. I think that's 80, yep. I was right. It gets hot right there. Very interesting. So yeah, they call it the Ship of Fools because most people are down there lazy, they're dumbed down. You don't have to be, you're already smart. See the pygmies? I forgot what that said, I was reading it. It's just, some of it's in a different language. But it just tells you on each island which one is, which is which. This one here is just like unbelievable resources, which is probably, I'm assuming, coming right out of that. Yep, land of milk and honey. So you know what to do, man. The Great Seal of the United States awaits. And let me show you. I don't even know. I think I found one on the ground somewhere. Nope, I don't even. Nope. Look on the back of your own dollar. The Great Seal of the United States, it says it right there. So if you're in the United States, or any state, or any of the seven powers, you would be owned by the seven powers. You think it's about government and politics, it's not. You would be owned by the Great Seal, which would be the all-seeing eye, which would be them, Luciferians. So if you are a state citizen, if you are a U.S. citizen, you would be owned by them. There's no government. It's all a fucking lie. So I'm just letting you know that shit, it was a fucking very fabulous lie. And TV is a lie, and it's all a motherfucking lie. You can keep dreaming, or you can realize that the only thing that was never on your school map is your only remedy, and now it's just being rubbed in your face, consistently in the movies, consistently everywhere, and you have a choice to either wake up or stay asleep. But I suggest stay awake.